host of our show, Up Your Arts board member and fellow musician, Bob Gentile.
Well, hello there, and welcome to Live from R&B's House. My name is Bob Gentile, and I'm honored to be asked, or have been asked, to be tonight's guest host. And a few things that you need to know. Tonight, we're live on Facebook. We're live on YouTube and Twitch. Never heard of Twitch, but we're on Twitch.
No one's had her Twitch.
I guess so. Each week, this has been going on each week in live concerts live at R&B's House hosts, and we're really, really happy and excited tonight because we have a wonderful band for you. But before I get to introducing them, I just want to let you know that this evening is to benefit Up Your Arts. Up Your Arts is a local non-for-profit organization that supports creative and performing arts. I happen to be on their board of directors. They're from Southport. We're out of Southport, but we promote, support artists, musicians, performers in the local area, and we're going to talk a little bit about that later on. There's ways that you're going to be able to help us by donating. There's a button there right in front of you on your Facebook page and YouTube that you'll be able to donate. But again, we'll talk about that later on. So tonight we have a special treat. We're going to hear the debut of R&B's House Band with our guest artist, Sandra Waddell. Hello, Sandra. How are you?
Hey, how are you?
Welcome. I'm glad you're here with us.
Glad to be here.
And I just wanted to learn about you, learn about where you're from and a little bit of your background. And obviously, you know Ronnie Weinstein. And I have to tell you that when I met Ronnie, it was at an open mic, and I mentioned this to you earlier. And I think everybody met Ronnie at an open mic.
True.
And
that's
how I met him, and I also had the pleasure of performing here, like you guys are doing, at R&B's House. So how did you meet Ronnie Weinstein?
I was visiting my aunt, and she said, hey, they have open mic down at the Lazy Turtle. I'm like, well, I'm all over that. Let's go. So I get down there, and the guys are awesome, and she went up and kind of whispered to them, you know, my niece is here, and she liked to get up and sing with the guys, and so they called me up, and I think I did House of the Rising Sun.
And she was hired instantly.
One of my favorite songs.
She got the gig.
She got the gig on House of the Rising Sun?
You know,
okay.
I just kept coming down and visiting. Every time I'd come visit, I would always go to open mic. And then I finally got to move down here.
Okay.
In 2018. So.
Okay. And how long ago was that? You said you were from Winston-Salem.
I am from Winston-Salem.
Okay. And how long have you been down in these parts?
It will be 3 years, May the 5th.
3 years, May 5th. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. And how are you finding it so far?
I love it, and I don't regret 1 minute of moving down here.
Yeah,
so.
It's pretty amazing how much live music is down here and how many wonderful musicians like these people behind you. It's actually quite amazing that there's that many down here. So tell us a little bit about your music background. And
I've been singing since I was five.
Five.
About
okay.
the time I was 11, I discovered Fleetwood Mac and Heart.
Okay.
And that's when I really got serious. I would spend hours and hours sitting by the stereo learning songs. And I did a few solos in high school, but okay. I was never in a band until I was 44.
Okay.
When I joined my sister and brother-in-law's band. It was a classic rock and blues band.
And you were hooked. That was it,
I
right?
was hooked. Yeah, I'd done a little bit of karaoke before then. But I was with them for 4 years, and then that broke up, and I joined a hard rock band. And
okay.
from there, I formed an acoustic duo with a guy from Greensboro, and we were together for 4 years until I moved down here. I had to split that duo up, which was very sad to do because we were we played a lot of shows in 4 years.
No, I got that. Yeah. So you had a lot of experience up there singing.
I did. Yeah. We played anywhere from 2 to 4 nights a week for 4 years.
That's great. Later on, we're going to talk a little bit about some of your special projects and the band that you've put together now.
All right.
We'll talk about that a little bit later. But there's something else that I learned about you, and that is you are an artist with jewelry and design.
I do. I'm actually a graphic designer by trade. That's how I really make my living, but I do jewelry and do things with shells. I have to do something with my obsessive hobby of looking for shells, but I make mermaids and, yeah.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Well, and now you're doing some of that down here?
I am. I do some of the farmers markets and
great.
Sell some of my stuff. Yeah.
That's great. Well, that's exciting. We're really happy that you're here with us tonight. And as I mentioned earlier, it's the debut of R&B's house band. And R over here. And anyway, so So without any further ado, as they say, let's get right to it and play some music. How's that sound, guys? All right. All righty.
Thank you. think so.
Okay, let's go
all
home.
Right. Let's do the next one.
Oh.
A little Stevie Nicks Tom Petty tune for you. Say hello to everybody in Winston-Salem. Hopefully, I got some people watching.
Sing it, girl. Terry Waddell. Hoots.
That's my sister. My sis. Thanks for watching, Terry. I'm a lookalike now.
Let's go.
We're both blonde now. We look just alike. Thank you.
weak, but all love is fair. I turn the other cheek, and I feel the slap and the sting of the foul night air. And I know you're only human, and I haven't got talking room. But tonight, while I'm making excuses, some other woman is making love to you.
Sorry.
We've been here all night.
This We've been fun. Here since Tuesday night.
Mentally. Oh,
here we go.
All right, the devil.
Now for the tough one, yeah.
Never seen eyes so blue. You know I could not run away, it seemed. CDJ someone by the past default tried to realize it all. Mom said she's worried, going up in a hurry. Yeah. Come on home, girl. Mama cried on the phone. Too soon to lose my baby, and my girl should be at home. But try to understand, try to understand. It's a magic man, Mama.
Okay, my goodness. Well done. Well done. That was quite impressive, that last song. All I can tell you is that you've obviously put some time in on that last song, and I love the Erik. I love your kicking.
Oh, my kicking.
Yeah. That's really good. Yeah, that was perfect. My goodness. Well, we're live. We're live from R&B's house once again, and with Sandra Waddell and the R&B House Band, and it's as I mentioned earlier, it's their debut. So at this point, what I'd like to do is just hand it over to R over here, Ronnie, and have him introduce the band. And I'll tell you, you weren't this introduce, all of you. That was really great. Really loved what I heard.
That's really awesome, Bob. I just wanted to let everybody know a little bit about this project. But before we get into that, I want to give a special shout out to Jason Pullen of Sound Evolution.
Jason.
Hello, Jason. Who's running sound for us over there. Everything's done digitally now, so he's got a little iPad there. He could be 200 feet away, but he's got us locked in, so we appreciate that. He actually does a lot of sound engineering work for Christine Martinez band when we play out, so we're really grateful for that, and a bunch of other folks as well. One thing I just want to just take a moment of pause. Christine Martinez is usually the host of our show, and tonight she's not able to make it. Prayers to her family. Her mom actually passed in the beginning part of this week. So our heart goes out. Please give whatever thoughts, prayers, and energy you can towards the family, because obviously I know they're struggling right now, and she's a very good friend. And so we miss her being here, but at the same time, she's with her family, so condolences to everybody for that. One of the things I wanted to just talk about, the inception of this project, and actually it's been something on the forefront of my mind to actually do something together. As you know, I've kind of modeled the bar is Daryl Hall's Live from Daryl's House, and of course that's a major bar, because anybody who watches that show, it is just stellar how they put everything together. But that was the whole concept of bringing things together here. We wanted to, there's a lot of very good front people in the area that either play with other bands or they're duos and they just don't front the band. So we wanted to put together this house band, and Erik had actually been on my ear for the longest time that we really should do that. We really should do it. Really should do that. So sure enough, it came around and we decided to make that happen. And of course, it's a matter of picking the right players. So of course, Erik was a given for me. Plays beside me in Christine's band, and so he's actually from the Fredonia School of Music in New York, and so he's all the way from that cold country. So he felt really at home this morning here, because it was really cold.
We moved south for a reason, boys and girls.
We're grateful to have Erik part of this southern community now. And if I was considered to be the band director, I have to say my the assistant band director, or my co-band director, is Mike Mitchem on guitar there. Mike keeps me in check. I needed somebody that was going to say, Ronnie, that's not right. So I needed a little bit of that, and Mike is real good about that. Basically, if there's somebody close as anal as me, it could be Mike when it comes to music. But he's right on. He's stellar, and love to have you, Mike. Thank you. And we've been wanting to play together for years, and we have played together. But this is awesome here. And then back here, holding it down, we got Scotty Pease on the drums.
That's right.
And Scotty actually and I have played together somewhat throughout, like on open mics or parties and things like that. But he's been, you know, a sideman with Mike Mitchem and other projects there. And he's played around town with John Tatum and a bunch of different people. So we're grateful for having Scotty here as well. So that's really the concept of the band. And we're going to, on a monthly basis, we're going to have a front person with the band. And I have to tell you, and I appreciate all the work that everybody's done, this is not a paid gig. I do give them water, okay? But it is not.
I paid for mine.
Well, you brought your own water, but I had water for you.
And no.
Okay, let's not go there. But the bottom line.
I got a sandwich.
Platter, nothing.
I'd like.
Someone for a green room.
Hey,
yeah, thanks.
Definitely Brad. Okay, we're live, guys. We're live.
Oh, sorry.
I reel it in. So just the one thing I wanted to say, that this was not an easy project, and and Bob will find out about the impetus of where this project originated from. And so it took a lot of hours and a lot of rehearsal time, and these songs were not all cakewalks, especially Magic Man.
So these guys threw their paces.
She actually did.
And made the mistake of letting me pick my own songs.
And we're grateful for Sandra being here, because this lady's got some vocal chops, and I've always wanted to do some with her. So
I'm honored to be here. I was tickled to death.
Thank you. Ran
into Ronnie out in the parking lot at Lowe's.
That was
Home
it?
Improvement when he said, "Sandra, I'm putting together a house band, and I want you to be first up." I'm like, yay!
Doesn't everybody run into him at Lowe's, I think?
So I'll turn her back over to the Bob, and then we'll get started with some more music.
All right. Well, thank you, Ronnie, and thank you for introducing everybody. Sandra, I do have another question. I have a couple of questions for you before we can get back to playing some music, and I'm going to talk a little bit about Up Your Arts and one of the reasons why we're here this evening. How did you pick your set list tonight? Was there a process you went through? Or?
Just some of the songs that I've been doing for years, but I haven't gotten to do in a while.
Okay.
And okay. I'd been jamming, going to open mic, and I hadn't done any of these songs with anybody at open mic. So I thought, you know, it'd be fun just to do some different stuff and give the people out there something different to listen to.
Sure.
So, and I wanted to rock it out a little bit, so, you know.
Well, you didn't pick easy ones. You really worked these guys behind you, I have to tell you. They must have spent a lot of time really working on some, especially like I told you, that last song. And I understand you have a new project. Am I saying it right? Salty Dogs?
The Salty Dogs are out of St. James. Almost everybody in the band lives in St. James except me and the lead guitarist. But I joined them. It was a year ago in September. Wow. You know, about the time we started getting some dates booked, COVID hit. So we've been practicing in the practice room once a week and just staying at it and hoping we'll get out there someday.
Well, that's great.
Yeah.
That's great. Wish you a lot of luck on that. It sounds
Thank
like you got a great, you know, great yep. start with all of that. And,
yeah, we are. We're booked April 18th at American Fish, which is a Sunday. So great. Hopefully that's going to get to happen. So we're excited about that.
American Fish, my goodness. It's great that they're going to be open and all that's happening. And, I mean, one of the reasons why this is here is to keep live music going. And, you know, Ronnie, you and Bev have really been gracious in opening your home to do this. I know I said this the last time I was on air with you, and I really mean it. And I know I speak for everybody here and everybody out there. Thank you. Thank you so much for your time and effort.
Yes. Yes.
And not only are they opening their home and getting wonderful musicians here to entertain us during these crazy times, we're doing it for a cause. We're doing it for an organization called Up Your Arts. And Up Your Arts, as I mentioned earlier, they support performing and creative arts in many different ways. They have a lot of projects. They're out of Southport. I happen to be on their board of directors, so I'm very honored to be on their board. And I have to tell you, I can assure you of this. If you donate tonight in any way, whether you go on the website, which is upyourarts.org, www.upyourarts.org, or if you just click on Facebook or YouTube, your money will go to a good cause. We have a number of projects going on, one of which you may have already heard, and I'm going to just briefly talk about it because we want to get back to listening to some more music, and that is we're trying to save the old town hall down there. It's called Save the Hall, y'all. I can't even say that right because I'm not from down here. I'm from Massachusetts.
Save the Hall, y'all.
Yeah.
So
Save the Hall, y'all. And and yes, we're looking to save the save the hall.
Mike, say it.
Save that hall, y'all.
Okay. That's good. That's good. So at any rate, that's one of our projects, and along with many others. But our primary mission is to support performing and creative arts. And when we get this hall up, that's what it's going to do. It's going to have, and you can go on our website and you learn a lot about what we'll do. It'll be a performing stage. And we're asking a lot of local people like Jason, who does a lot of sound for a lot of bands around here, to give us advice and input on how we can get the right sound system in that building. So that's one of our projects, along with many other ones. We're going to talk a little bit about who's playing and where and how live music is going to start and get going. So just remember, we're live on our R&B's House on Facebook, and you can subscribe as well on YouTube. Am I saying all these things right, Ronnie?
Yeah, you said YouTube perfectly, Bob.
Did
even
I?
Though YouTube? You're even though you're from Massachusetts,
I could say YouTube.
It's perfect. Yeah.
Okay, so what do you say we get? Oh, I love this guy back here. All right, so let's get back to playing some music.
Absolutely.
All right, terrific.
Play it sweetly, Ron.
We good to go, Jason?
Take me now, baby, here as I am. Pull me close. close, try and understand. Desire is hunger, is the fire I breathe. Love is a banquet on which we feed.
Problem. Hang on a second.
Medic.
we're going to do a song about Joe Cocker. It was a remake of Gary Wright's Love is Alive. And this one happens to rock a little bit more than the original. Just a little bit.
It has a Sandra influence.
This one's really fun.
It's your fault, Sandra. It's your fault it rocks so hard. You good? Let's rock.
We'll be right back.
born to rock.
I got a tune.
Oh, I hate these guitar players with this tuning stuff.
You came to practice the other day on the tune on that piano. How's that even possible?
Yeah, we are grateful for guitarists that tune.
Oh, God.
Because there are definitely two guitarists that do not tune but need to tune.
I do it and it still don't help.
You guess you bend the crap out of those strings, brother.
There to do it too.
All right, we got a couple more for you.
Oh, let's get running.
I've enjoyed this thoroughly. Thank you guys for having me.
Yeah. Thanks for coming. Come sit.
And after that, we're going to do the hokey pokey.
That might be our last cha-cha-cha ending.
Move it all around.
You put your left you peek.
Anyway. We're going to leave you with some Melissa Etheridge. One more tune from her.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Gotta love Melissa.
Great job,
oh, Missy.
Sandra.
We like Missy.
Pleasure playing with you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Let's start.
Please, baby, can't you see my mind's a burning hell?
Awesome.
Thank you very much.
Hey, it's Bob's going to come up, take us out, but I'll tell you, it's a privilege playing with this lady. I'm sure all the guys want to say something also.
This has been awesome. Appreciate it.
Bravo.
So fun.
So
fun. It's been much fun.
That was fun.
Thank you.
My goodness, that was amazing. That was absolutely, Melissa. I mean, really, that was like, I mean, really, Jason and I are out there going, she sounds great. Really, absolutely. One beautiful voice. Fantastic. And you guys, I got to learn some of your moves. That's all I got to know.
We'll review the tape.
We'll review the tape
later and send it in slow motion to you so you get the full effect.
I don't know, Erik. You got a few of them down. All of you are absolutely fantastic. At this point, as you all know, we're live from R&B's house. And at this point, what I want to talk about is, and you already mentioned a date that Salty Dogs are playing at the American Fish.
Yes.
Are there any other dates that you have at this point? And I know it's hard because
we are supposed to be doing a benefit for Matthew's ministry.
Cool. Okay. Oh, very good.
End of March. I don't have the exact date.
What was the date again on American Fish?
18th of April.
April.
Which is a Sunday afternoon.
Okay. Terrific.
Yep. So y'all come.
All right.
Absolutely.
All right. And I just want to remind you that save the dates for Live and R&B because we have Thursday, February 11th. We have Radio Rehab, our very own Jason Pullen's band right out here doing sound tonight. That's February 11th.
2 weeks here. From tonight.
2 weeks from tonight. And then Thursday, February 18th, we have Gary Texter with the R&B House Band. Right here. My goodness, they're really working, you guys. Huh?
Right?
Yeah, right.
Union. I'm saying union. I'm saying
I hope
union.
They give you a little more than water next time. Right here. Yeah. Also, I would be remiss if I didn't mention one more thing about Up Your Arts. We have a fundraising event for Up Your Arts that is going to be on April 24th at the Jetport. And the band that I'm in, Luna C, is the headliner band, and we're going to be playing there, as well as Dave's Not Home. So please come out April 24th at the Jetport. Again, all the monies that goes there, we got a lot of people volunteering, so all the monies that goes there that we'll be raising on that event will go to Up Your Arts.
And for Luna C, wear your polka dots.
Wear your polka dots, absolutely.
Absolutely,
and be ready for it. It's a 7-piece horn band, and we put on a show, and it's a lot of fun. Jason, once again, you're like everywhere. You're Sound Evolution. Yes, I know. And you're like you're gonna be doing all the sound for all of us.
Wave, Jason.
Thank you, Jason. So April 24th, Luna C, and Dave's Not Home to raise money for Up Your Arts. We'd love for you all to be out and doing that with us. And so tonight. There's a lot of thank yous going on. Thank you, Ronnie Beverly, for making your show happen and keeping us in music, live music alive.
Hey, and who's doing the camera work out there? Who's on the X?
We have Beverly out there handling the cameras. Yay! Yes, Beverly.
Yay, Beverly. Yeah.
Sweet, quiet Beverly out there doing. You really work her hard, I'll tell you.
And, of course, Jason's still up there. He's working up a sweat, so can we see Jason there?
He doesn't
again?
Look like he's doing
Jason,
much.
Calm
but
down
yeah,
down
Jason's
there,
out
man.
There
really,
doing.
Calm down.
He's Jason is running our sound. And you know what? Let's.
There's Jason.
There's Jason right there.
Hard at work.
Hard work.
And let's not forget the most important part of our crew. That's Lucy and Little Ricky.
Yeah,
Lucy and Little Ricky. That's right.
Little Ricky was a little rambunctious.
Got
put in jail?
He's in jail, but he's going to come out any second.
Well, everybody loves Lucy and Little Ricky. And I'm Bob Gentile. I'm your guest host for the evening. Thank you.
Nice.
Thank
Great
you.
Great job, Bob. Good Thank job, you so much.
You're welcome. Appreciate you're welcome. That. Happy to do it. And good night, folks. Good night, everybody.
And we're out.